Hello everyone, my name is Pawan Puri and today we are going to study the subject dynamics of machinery, in which first of all we are going to see what is exactly mean by vibration, because first three units are of vibration, then the fourth unit is of balancing of machine, and fifth and sixth units are of different techniques, different instruments of measuring vibration and noise. So first of all, we will see the definition of vibration. So I can say, when an elastic body, let's take example of shaft or spring, which is fixed at one end and it is displaced at another end. So let's suppose from its equilibrium position, by an application of some external force or by the force of your hand, we can say, the body will start to move to and fro distance, to and fro motion, or will try to execute up and down motion, or will try to twist and do the untwist, then body is said to be in equilibrium position. So we can say the vibration can be called as mechanical phenomena whereby oscillation occurs by an equilibrium point. The main cause of vibration, we can say, it's the intermolecular forces generated within the body, which will try to reduce the external force applied by your hand or by some other means. Means when the body particles are displaced by the application of external force, the internal force in the body will try to form an elastic energy and will try to deform the body. We can take the example of vibrations as when we are sitting in our home or any place where we are fully partially touching the ground, and suddenly earthquake comes, which shakes everything. That can be called as a vibration phenomena. Or when a fully automatic machine stops rotating in the end, vibrates too much, we try to execute its motion, that can be also called as vibration. Extraordinary motion of anything around is considered as vibration. This is the main line. The extraordinary motion of any around is considered as vibration. I can give you one best example of a simple pendulum. Let's suppose we have a simple pendulum which is attached to the fixed support at its upper end, and one string is there, and to that string one bob is attached, that bob, and the position B is called as equilibrium position or its initial position. When we will try to give a small displacement to that point B, that bob B, that bob B will try to displace to point C, or let's suppose to point A, and that rotation, that movement will be goes on continuous to the infinite time, until and unless some internal forces are generated within the body to oppose that external force. So what exactly happening is here, when we are applying any external force on the system, at that time some intermolecular forces will try to oppose your external force. What exactly is happening over here? Due to application of your internal forces to oppose your external forces, the body will try to generate a strain energy, and that strain energy will try to convert into other form of energy. We can say it as a kinetic energy. So at point C or at point A, let's take example, we have given initial displacement to B towards right hand. So at point C, we will get maximum kinetic energy. If we are getting maximum kinetic energy to the body at point C, so I think it will not stop at the point C. It will try to move, because at that time it is having a maximum kinetic energy. So from C it will try to come at B. Kinetic energy will be converted into strain energy or potential energy. So from potential energy, again that point, again that energy will be converted into kinetic energy or potential. So this energy conversion will be continuously goes on. So this energy conversion will continuously goes on because of this energy conversion, our body will be continuously in the motion, or we can say will continuously in the oscillation. So this is the main reason of vibration. okay? So we can say when an elastic body such as spring or shaft are displaced from the equilibrium position by the application of some external force and then release, they execute a vibratory motion. This is due to reason that when body is displaced, the internal forces in the form of elastic or strain energy are present in the body. At the release, these forces will bring the body to its original position. When body reaches to the equilibrium position, the whole of the elastic energy is converted into kinetic energy, due to which body continue to move in the opposite direction also, as we have we can say in towards A position. The whole kinetic energy is again converted into strain energy, due to which body again return to its equilibrium position. In this way, the vibratory motion is repeated indefinitely. Okay, what are the main causes of vibration? We can say the unbalancing in the system. We can take best example of a car. After particular driving of particular kilometers, some unbalance comes into the picture. Because of that, vibration may get involved in your car. Lack of lubricants between two mating surfaces. Yes, this can be the also the reason for main cause for vibration. Then external load or force, which may make the system vibrant. Lack of balancing. You must know the concept of balancing. We generally do the balancing of our vehicles, or you must have heard how the balancing are done. That balancing is done to reduce the vibrations also. Earthquakes can be the example of vibration. Winds which may causes vibration in transmission and telephone lines. Yes, this can also be the example. Whether the vibration is harmful or not. So I can say vibration is also harmful, and in some cases it is also useful. So where it is generally a harmful, so we can say produce excessive stresses which may produce undesirable noise also, which may also reduce the machine element life, partial or complete failure of machine. It is also possible, and energy waste, this is also possible due to vibration. So these are the harmful causes of vibration. There are also some good advantages, we can say advantages of vibrations also. We can take an example of musical instruments. In every musical instrument, we can say the vibration is the main phenomena where your music gets to us. Then we can say a vibrating screen. We also know there are various stress relieving equipments in the market. These are the main they run on the concept of vibration only. In mobile phones, in motion of turning for vibration in loudspeaker. So these are some good advantages or the advantages of vibrations. Okay, after that we will see how we can reduce the vibration, or we can eliminate the vibration. We can say we cannot eliminate vibration 100% from any system, but we can try to reduce that system, try to reduce the vibration. There are different techniques. We can use shock absorbers in the vehicle to reduce the vibration. Again, we can use the vibrating absorbers, isolators, also the examples of different techniques to reduce the vibration. Okay, then we will go for the different point, the next point, that is a type of vibration. So there are two, three types of vibration, and it depends upon the first type of vibration depends upon the force, which force you have applied. So there are two types of vibration in this category. First one is free vibration or natural vibration, in which we can say if you are applying, let's take an example of simple pendulum. If you are applying if you are giving initial displacement to that body, that simple pendulum, and we will take your hand. Let's take an example of simple pendulum. When we are giving some external, we will apply initial displacement to the body, and then we will that system will try to vibrate automatically until and unless some damping is applied or some external force or internal forces are applied to stop that body. So this type of vibrations are called as free vibration. And in force vibration, if that simple pendulum is there and you are applying a continuous vibration to that continuous external force after some periodic time, let's say I am applying a force to that simple pendulum, initially I will apply it, then after 2 minutes I will apply it, then after 4 minutes I will apply it. So these kind of vibrations are called as force vibration. The next point, I already mentioned this, what is free vibration. I also mentioned what is force vibration. Next, we will